Dude, shut up.
Pat motherfucking Brown in the house. I got my phones on, I gotta get my grub on some thought. Order 3 buckets of mama, we getting mama dough off the books. You getting jelly, pulling mama off the look. You getting jelly, you won't hate me, cause your wifey wants an autograph. From looking in her eyes, I can see she wants more than that. When I see finances, I'll make fat pass like.
My name is Pat, and I live in Woodinville, Washington, and attend Woodinville High School. And I enjoy eating Cocoa Puffs.
Nice, yeah.
See, B here could freestyle, so I was stoked, because I'm an MC. I'm kind of whack. I'm kind of whack, but I'm not as bad as the kid next door, so it's all good.
Funny.
Yeah, I don't know, you kind of got on my nerves, though, with your jock stereotypes. You're always bashing jocks, because that just bugs me, because I'm a jock. And like, yeah, I am. Dude, shut up, I'm going to on the football team. I'll do it. Let me break out my running shorts. Is a kid I know up north. I used to be friends with. I'm still friends with him, so I just don't hang out with him as much as I used to. He's kind of a retard. Jim here was always just, I don't know, he just like had a good outlook, you know? And he's always just like even with that, the whole, that night game, like, I don't know, now everyone seems to think it was great, but I just remember we had to walk around in the dark and be quiet. And the only reason any of us enjoyed it was because we weren't quiet. It's true. But, like, Jim's still just like, oh, yeah, man, it was great. Oh, it was great fun, you know, but I know what's up. Tony's just a cool guy. He'd try to, like keep us down, you know, and try to, like, be all authoritative. But he'd just, like, give up half the time. It seemed like it was no good. Like, this is the coolest thing. This is the coolest thing ever. Like, when I first started to climb up in this closet, Tony's like, dude, Pat, don't go in there. Don't go in there. And then I go in there, and I'm just sitting in there, and then you're like, yo, we should just get someone else in there, and then, like, you can both, like, stick your heads out of the closet, and you're just totally with it as soon as I was in the closet. And I thought that was just, like, the coolest thing ever. You're just, like, mellow, and you're, like, a great counselor. Yeah, you're a great counselor because you never told me what to do, and I liked it.
Ow!
Whoa, cool.
Awesome.
I gotcha.
Alright, man.
I wanna sleep in there.
Oh, dude, this thing's
going
to
work.
Dude, what are you doing?
On board.
What?
Dude,
Pat.
Go, Pat.
Why?
No, Pat, don't listen to him. Go.
Great. Pat, get out.
No, dude.
Don't.
All the way, dude.
What?
I'm saying don't listen.
It's stable.
I'll let you go in the closet.
Dude, this is dope. Check this out. I can stick my head out the top and you can sleep in here. Look at this. Hello.
Oh, I spilled.
I dare you to sleep up there.
Throw him my pillow. Throw him right there. You're right next to it, Jason.
Wake us up trying to get out.
Jason, pillow.
I'm getting it, dude. Aw.
Put it through one of those doors.
So do you want to hear my story about like what I did one night over spring break?
Yeah,
that's my story.
Oh, all right. So like, it was spring break. It was Monday night, and my parents were gone for the week, and my friends Barry, Anthony, and Matt were over at my house, and like we're sitting in my house, we watched CKY2K, and we're just like, dude, I feel like doing something kind of crazy now. We're just like, aight. And so like, we're just like, what should we do? And then we're like, hey, let's go to that gravel yard in Kenmore, which is this town like 15 minutes from my house, like two towns over. So we're like, okay, so we go out there, and like,
What time is this?
Well, this is at about probably midnight that we leave. So we get the gravel yard like, I don't know, 12:30, 1 or so, something like that. It was probably like 1.
That was 15 minutes away.
Well, I don't know. It was sometime around then. I wasn't really keeping track of time. Shut up! Yeah, so like, we get out there, and there's this conveyor belt. It's like 100 feet off the ground. It's like this wide. And like, my friend Matt, like, climbs across it. And then at the very end, there's this huge hill of gravel that's like, I don't know, it's like 50 feet tall or something. It's like a 30-foot drop from the top of the conveyor belt into the gravel. So he like climbs out there and he just sits there for like 10 minutes. He's like, Pat. And I was like, what? He's like, what would you do if you were out here? I was like, I'd jump. He's like, you would? I was like, there's no way in hell I'd climb back. And he's like, oh, okay. And he just like stands up. He's just like, and like jumps. And it's like 30 feet just into this huge hill of gravel. We got it on film too. All right, we got the whole night on film.
Yeah, Dan just like knows what's up, you know. He just like, he could be like kind of stubborn a lot of times. I could tell, you know, like he doesn't like being wrong or being told like what to do. Like doesn't like to, like he'll argue with people about anything, seems like. He knows what he wants to do, and that's always important, you know. It's like something I don't really do. And Kyle here. Yeah, Kyle's just a good guy. What? Sure, boy. And like, he's just like, you can be a gentleman. He just like knows right and wrong, and will show like what's right and wrong. Like me, I think I have an alright sense of what's right and wrong, but I just kind of ignore it. And unlike Kyle, he's just a good guy. I'll leave it at that. That just about sums it up. Oh, you're gonna lock me in, Kyle? I heard your plan. This is why I gotta say that.
Hey! Oh! Oh my god!
Oh, this is classic! Hey, can I get in there?
What?
I need to go to the bathroom. Come on, fool, I need to go to the bathroom.
I'm crapping.
Ow.
Come on, dude, I gotta take a crapper. Hold on, I'll take it off. Hold up.
Isn't that pretty sick?
Aw, oh, dude!
Someone like,
why can't we get any answers?
Pooped in a bag and left it in the cabin.
What's it doing?
Dude,
it's my hat! That's a great idea!
Do you want? So are you.
Oh, no, let's poop in a bag!
I'm all about pooping in bags. I've told you about my poop bag experience. Yes.
That's cool, you're getting married.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Yeah, that's something to be proud of. I'd definitely be proud of that if I was getting married.
He said, like, every Friday he goes down to the high school at the football games and gets all these girls' numbers. It's hilarious. It's all the high school girls' numbers. Just comes back to the park next year, the whole sheet of them. God, so cool.
No, just, like, before this week, I couldn't even, like, talk to girls. It was crazy. And if I would, I'd just say something retarded. Like this one time, like, I was in this park, and these girls kept walking by like 5 times, and me and my friend were just like, dude, gotta talk to them. So finally, I just go, hey. Then she turns around and just goes like this. And just like, keeps the face for like 30 seconds. I'm just like, hi. And she's like, I'm like, how you doing? And she's like, and I was like, won't come sit down. And she's just like, and then she finally kept walking, and I just like felt like the biggest moron. I had no skills whatsoever. But Matt here is a little Don Juan. I overheard a rumor that a certain person that I know sort of performed oral favors to another person during the silent time on Wednesday. But I knew it wasn't true.
Sweet.
No, it friend. Sweet, dude. Yeah, so, you know, I mean, he's had a girlfriend for a year. That's something to be proud of, I'd say. So I couldn't even get a girlfriend.
Quarterback, beat nuts, all of that. Yours, quarterback. Hoping I'm dead, I have you fooling with my cheddar heart.